welcome back to The Big Picture, where we are talking drones with Willy Saget. He is the president of the Swiss Federation of Civil Drones. And with his help, we'll be getting up close and personal with a variety of drones. And the drones will be getting up close and personal with us. And you will be able to see our studio like never before. So, Willy, how about you take her for a spin, bitte?
Yeah.
Come to mama. Great. Now, I have to tell you, it always surprises me that, that something so small produces so much wind and that it's so loud.
Yes, you're right. But only small doesn't mean quiet, so the smallest can be louder than the bigger ones.
That is pretty surprising, actually.
Yeah.
I would think that the bigger ones, of course, would be louder.
No, even the small drones are packed with a lot of high-tech equipment and are very sophisticated. For example, this one, it's a consumer drone.
Ah, yeah, it has a camera here.
It's a camera drone, yes. Yeah.
And you can walk into any shop and buy it or buy it online?
There are a lot of online stores who sell these kind of products, even shops, electronic shops, where almost everybody can buy his own drone.
And how heavy is this? What are we talking?
It's below the magical 500 grams barrier in Switzerland. That's a pretty important thing. So it's, I don't know, about 350 grams.
Okay, which to clarify, it falls below that threshold of regulation.
Oh, so not all regulation, to be clear on that. So
okay.
It falls under the threshold of some regulations, but there are still some left, like not flying reckless against humans or animals, and, of course, all the data protection regulations.
And so when does, for example, this question of data protection and privacy come into play? When is this an issue?
Yeah, always.
It's always an issue.
Yeah, of course.
Even for the little ones. So don't think that just because you have a small drone, everybody that's watching here, that just because you have a small one doesn't mean that you can get away with whatever, right?
It doesn't depend on the size of the drone or the camera. Even when you make photographs with your smartphones, you are under these regulations of data protection. With a drone, you can see at places where maybe an owner of a house doesn't want you to see in. And that's another story. So you must be careful where to fly and what to do with your cameras. Always, even with the small ones.
How much is this, for example, if I wanted to buy this?
Yeah, I know. For you, I make a special price.
You better.
Yeah. No, they are in a range of about 600, 650 Swiss francs.
It's a good chunk of change, but less than an iPhone.
Yes, there are cheaper ones, but they are fully equipped with GPS and a pretty good stabilized camera, so you can work with these drones, make good pictures, but they don't fly so long, they don't fly so wide, and it's not so sophisticated from the camera. There are others who do it better, but for entrants, for starting with drones, this model is a very good choice.
And then after this, we've got this one. All right, let's do this one. Sizes, and now we have, what is this?
Yes,
this looks like a spaceship.
No, it's a DJI Phantom 4. That's one of the
Phantom 4.
It's one of the most well-known drones. This shape they made with this drone, that's what people think of when they say it's a small drone. And that's a model a lot of broadcasting companies use, a lot of video enthusiasts use, because the camera is
very good. Because it flips
very
the camera
good.
And...
And
the
speciality here is it's used by a lot of police organizations. Because it's waterproof, you can fly in almost every weather, and it is here equipped with very sophisticated cameras with thermographic imaging where you can see things at night.
This one sounds very pricey.
Yeah, oh yes, it is.
What are we looking at?
Yeah, equipped like that, it's about 30,000 Swiss francs.
30,000, okay. That's even a bigger chunk of change.
Yeah.
But we've got even one more big daddy over here.
Yes.
What is this?
And the biggest of them, maybe you can see it, it doesn't even have a camera. So it's,
what does it do?
Yeah, not all drones mandatorily have a camera, so they are used for a lot of things. This one, for example, is used for spraying pesticides in vineyards or in other fields where you have problems to drive with a tractor. You can take one of those guys and do the spraying from the air, which, again, needs some special permissions.
this one you would need some special training for, which you offer at the Swiss Federation of Civil Drones, which is just, the headline is what? What is it you do there?
So Swiss Federation of Civil Drones is an association of pilots of drones in Switzerland. We are about almost 700 people federated in this organization. We act together to work on the regulations in Switzerland, the regulations in Europe. We have our licensing exams and trainings, therefore, registration of drones. And that's not mandatory, but it's used by a lot of people who just want to do trainings and do some licensing to show, to prove that they do it seriously and they do it compliant and don't harm any other people or the nature.
How busy do you think our skies could get?
Today it's not so busy, to be honest, but we don't know what the future will bring. There are a lot of very interesting projects running now, not only agricultural drones, but even delivering, parcel delivery.
Yes, exactly.
For example,
the Post is organizing deliveries.
Yes.
This is not something you've seen more of.
Yes, yes. Not to deliver parcels to your home in the first step, but company side to company side in some company campus connections. Yes, of course, yeah. And it's only a question of time until we will see person transport with drones. So no pilot in charge, but you just sit in, press your target, and you will be flown by a drone.
Well, they've done this. They've done some tests like this in the Middle East, I think, right?
In Dubai. Yes. So the technology is more or less available for a lot of such things, but it's very difficult to do the regulations on that, to provide a safe service, because nobody wants to go outside and drones fall out of the sky.
Do you want to take this baby for one last spin around the studio?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure, we'll do that.
All right, let's warm it up. I have to